These FAUSA conferences are wonderful, but when you go back to the States, the FAUSA getaways are a great opportunity to rediscover America, because that's pretty wonderful too. And we just listed a lot of the different places where we've had conferences or the FAUSA getaways. The most recent ones have been in Durango, Boston, where we had the FAUSA conference, Houston, and most recently in Charleston, South Carolina. But what's next? We're heading west. We're not going to the wine. Wait, the wine's coming to us, right? We're going to the wine. Napa Valley is located in Northern California, very close to San Francisco and the Pacific Ocean, and 360 miles from Los Angeles. San Francisco, Oakland, and Sacramento airports are all just over an hour away, so it's not too far to drive in from there. JetBlue is a cost-effective airline that flies into all three airports. Napa Valley is small. It's about 5 miles across and 30 miles long. There are a number of distinctive areas. FAUSA will concentrate primarily on Napa, Yountville, St. Helena, and Calistoga. Napa takes its name from the Wapo Indians who inhabited the area. Winemaking history is about 150 years old in Napa. And it started in Yountville, which is sometimes referred to as Kellerville, because of the chef Thomas Keller. Word spread about the natural abundance and temperate climate. And by the 1840s, Napa boomed with silver mines, lumber yards, steamships to San Francisco, and a railroad line. There's also healing spas in Calistoga, but the boom years didn't last. Prohibition, the mines went bust. The Great Depression. And by the time World War II came along, Napa's graveyards and wineries were largely abandoned and planted over to other crops like plums and walnuts. But after World War II, the industry recovered. It was a pivotal endorsement from another part of the world that helped put Napa on the map. The 1976 Judgment of Paris wine tasting, chronicled recently in the movie Bottle Shock, set the wine world on its ear. Few could have imagined that California wines could win such a competition, yet California wines rated best in each category. The hard work of Napa's vintners were paying off. We have found a wonderful hotel that's along the banks of the Napa River. It'll be our home for a few days in November. The inn offers a river view, fitness room, pool and spa, room refrigerator for wines. I know our group. Business center, free wireless internet, and free parking. The hotel has well-appointed and reasonably priced rooms, and for a slight upgrade fee of $35, you can secure a river view, which is worth it to me. There's an attractive patio with wire pits just outside of our meeting room. And the River Terrace Inn is a few short blocks from the fabulous Oxbow Market, which is filled with food, restaurants, different shops, and the delights of downtown Napa are just an easy walk from the hotel, just about 4 blocks away. This is it, Oxbow Market. After a wine tasting, one of many, on our first night, we'll adjourn just across the parking lot from the hotel to the restaurant Cuvée for a drink and light dinner, and then on to our private dining room. I'm very excited about this. On Friday, we will join the Honorable Catherine Wall Hall, former ambassador to Vienna at Hall Vineyards in St. Helena, for a private tour and tasting, and Ambassador Hall is going to share with us some of her experiences of repatriating back to the U.S., because ambassadors have to repatriate also. We'll have the opportunity to visit wineries such as Domaine Chandon and Chateau Montelena, which was in the movie Bottle Shop. We're planning to lunch at the CIA. Not that one, the other one, the Culinary Institute of America. We're going to explore Castello di Amoroso, which is a castle winery that was brought over. It was a castle in Italy that was brought over stone by stone and rebuilt in Calistoga. So we'll have a private tour there. Click through the slides real quick and finish up. There's lots of natural beauty, winery. We'll have the opportunity to take a balloon ride. Lots of shopping opportunities. The mud bath. It's really good for your skin. This was taken about 20 years ago, so it worked. The mud bath's everywhere. We're going to be there at the time of the crush, which is a very exciting time to be there. It's the harvest time. And I hope that you'll join us in a glass of wine in Napa, November 1st through 4th, and help rediscover America. Thank you.